you want. Leave us alone.
Yeah. How's it going, everybody? It's CRCast with Jeff Lockby, Jibber Redinger, and tonight, it's your Andy Siplon.
Woo!
Yeah, what's up, Mr. Randy Siplon?
What's going on, guys?
Frank's in the chat. Not much. Yeah. Who's got the train?
Oh, that's probably me.
Yeah.
Damn,
that's
it.
How you know it's on our cast. Usually it's me. Right? It's not me. It's Randy. Yeah. That's awesome.
Time to go on a late night hobo train ride.
That'd be great. Yeah. I wanted to do that as a kid. What about you guys?
Like, hell
just,
yeah.
You know, ride the rails and all that stuff?
Yeah, dude. It was all about that. And then that fucking one serial killer like was riding the rails and killing people. And you're like, oh, shit.
That's true.
Who was that? Y'all remember who I'm talking about?
I remember watching a documentary about it, but I don't remember what his name was. Yeah, what a lame-o.
Ruining hobo culture for everyone.
Yeah, for everybody. Yeah. Back in the day when hobos all wore top hats with the top blown out on it, you know? Dressed up like sad clowns, you know. The good old days.
Was it that far back though? I thought that was more modern than it. Yeah.
That was way more modern.
Yeah.
Like in the 80s, I think. Early 80s maybe.
Yeah.
God, man, I can't think of
I can look it up. Me. Train riding. Serial killer?
I'll be right back.
I think we need to know this. Do we even need to look this up now that Jim's gone?
Yeah. He'll probably come back and want to know.
Angelo Matrino. That doesn't sound right. I don't know. We'll ask you when we catch back. He can do his own search. So how's Kill Reaper doing?
It's
a big question.
It hasn't moved. It's I think Christmas has killed Kill Reaver.
Yeah. You know what? I was thinking about that today. And I was like, hey, man, this is like ending, you know, like a week before Christmas of all times.
Yeah. But, you know, I'll put it in demand and we'll see what happens.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Whoops.
Uh-oh.
I picked you. Oh, kick me out. Hit the wrong button.
Me on the bottom.
Oh, you're on the bottom? Yeah. That's where you ought to be, Joe, with my foot right
on the bottom. That's where
I'll be. It is Kill Reaver. If there's anybody out there besides Frank that needs to buy some Kill Reaver, go for it. It's your last chance. He's not going to put it in demand either. This is your only chance.
Oh, yeah. Did I say that? I'm sorry.
All I know is if you have a child out there, there's only chance of him becoming a man is if you buy him Kill Reaver.
Yeah.
He reads that book.
It's so, the best book out right now. How much time is on it? Let's see.
Three hours. Come on, dig deep.
Yeah. It'd be nice if I could hit 1,500. Yeah. But you know. Let's see.
Yeah, that would be get that unlock that
shuffle. Yeah. Cool. Yeah.
I wanna like share it real quick too. I haven't shared this thing all day.
So. How much do you need, Randy? As much as you can afford, Frank.
Yeah, what do you mean?
As much as you can afford, dig deep.
Or does he mean to hit 1,500? I don't know what he's saying.
I don't know, man. Maybe.
It's $38. It's been at $14.62 for like 10 days now.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah.
It's pissing me off.
Tell us how you really feel, Randy. Tell us how you really feel.
No, I'm good.
Oh, damn it.
Oh, am I supposed to do some rabble rousing?
Sure, there you go. If you need.
All right.
You
need. I don't know.
If you need. It's late. It's late. You know you work.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Good day at work. Did you do? Did you do any? Did you do any infinity symbols or?
No. What did I do? Trying to remember. Anything
behind the ear?
Yes. Yeah, no, the last thing. Well, I did like a dragon on this girl's arm.
Like a like an Asian dragon, like an.
Dragon? No, more like a kind of like a medieval type of. Lord that of kind Rings. Of dragon. Yeah, that kind of dragon. And then what else did I do? I can't remember. Oh, just like I did some shading that I had to finish up on like a
yes, session work.
Some it was like a girl's face, one of those like girl faces with the crying and laughing masks, you know, like that kind of like the black and gray kind of
Cholo work.
Yeah, that kind of thing, yeah.
Yeah. Bug.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was fun.
I'm gonna go on Twitter and like call out Comicsgate. Like, what there the fuck are you guys doing?
Oh Jesus!
Look at this book.
Jeff's like Jeff goes on a CG live stream and now he's all he's like EVS.
Jeff's back in, dude. They anointed him. It's all good.
Oh man,
he can do this. He's going on EVS's show next week.
Oh,
they told me like before we went on like backstage, they were kind of like Preston, he's filling me out in on like CG and all this stuff. I'm like, oh, okay. Obviously, I haven't watched some of my early videos.
Yeah. Just like, just go along with it. Just nod and smile. That's what I do.
Yeah.
There you go. Indie Gate news, Randy.
Indie Gate.
Went on some guy's live stream, like, couple weeks ago, and he like one of the things he asked me is like, are you part of, you know, he's like, are you with Comicsgate? And I was like, kind of, I paused for a second. I was like, what do you want me to say? Like, is it yes or no? Because I'm not sure if he was Comicsgate, but then he's like, yeah, I love Comicsgate. I'm like, oh yeah, yeah, Comicsgate's awesome.
There you go.
Oh my god. Well,
yeah, good way of not riding the fence there, Randy.
Right, yeah. Well it caught me off guard because he hadn't mentioned it. Like the whole I was talking to the guy for like, you know, a good amount of time and he never said anything about Comicsgate. So I was just like, whatever. Then all of a sudden he brought it up. I was like, But like I've said, I support the basic premises of Comicsgate. I just don't like everyone that's in it. So
yeah, we hate number one, Ethan S. Sky, or number two, Dutch Nagel. I have a hit list of people that I wish it were dead, and they're all gone.
Yeah. Well, I do too, but they're
abort,
not.
Where's the abort button? Abort mission. Fucking, oh damn! All right, this one's down.
There's only one way they're gonna stop us for liking these guys. The fucking kill reader hits like 5,000 tonight. There it is. Goddamn chance.
I just wanted to hit like, I'd like to get to like 40 backers. I think I'm at 37.
There you go.
You know, it's like. Come on. I think I've come to realize that like the people who are fans of my artwork like aren't really into comics. Yeah. So like it's kind of hurt. Like my trading card set did like way better, you know, and it's like
yeah.
I don't know. I think they just like my, you know, my portraits of like movie characters and stuff like that and they're not really into comics cuz it's like, you know, I think I have more than 37 fans of my artwork, but maybe not.
That's it.
Yeah.
Tapped out.
Maybe.
But you know how it is, man. This thing's gonna end, and you've been screaming for 2 months, going, "Oh my god, buy my fucking book!" And as soon as it ends, you know, it's like, "Oh, I didn't. Oh, you had something going on." It's like,
yeah.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
That's all I've talked about for 2 months.
Yeah, exactly, and you know, that's the thing. It's like I post it constantly on like social media. And then I'll make some kind of joke post about ranch dressing, and that'll get like 100, you know, comments on it. You know, it's like
I feel you.
That's so true. Yeah. I did notice that too. Like when you would post like something that would be inflammatory, every fucking idiot in the world has to come out of the woodwork to like shoot their mouth off.
Exactly. But if it's like, about my comic, there's like one like.
Yeah.
You know.
So what's Frank saying? Randy's, do donations go towards the goal?
Yeah. What?
I don't understand.
Sure. Wow. Yeah, the goal of life.
No, you can on Indiegogo. I mean, you can donate to it without getting a perk or whatever.
Oh, I see.
That's, I think, what he means. I hope. I don't know. Like,
EJB, what's here? Hey, dude.
What's up?
Yeah. I don't know. I really feel like we're like a lot alike. Because like we both did sketch cards, we both like built this whole thing up with commissions and that mm-hmm. kind of thing on eBay. And then when you switch to comics, it's like I think there's so many guys who sort of appreciate it, but then they don't, you know what I mean? They're not into that. They're into portraits of whatever, you know.
Yeah.
And I also noticed like with mine, it seemed like as when I was failing, there just seemed to be like so many guys who just would not donate. And then finally when it went over, like I finally made it over that hump, then all these guys that, you know, I thought like, where are these guys? They like, they buy everything. Why are they not coming? Then they showed up. It was just weird. It's almost like they were just kind of waiting to see if I failed so I'd get off this crazy comic.
Yeah. But you know, you got to stick to it.
Yeah.
Like I've even like gone on, some Comicsgate live streams and done the super chat thing like a lot of people do. And I think like one time I did it and I got like a backer right away. So I was kind of like, okay, maybe this is worth it. But then it's like, you know, I'm spending $5 a super chat to make, to get one backer. It's like, it's not worth it, you know? And like, but that's the way a lot of people have built up their following through Comicsgate is just doing that. Like,
yeah,
but you know, you got to spend money, you know, but.
Well, I wondered if that would work.
It has worked for a few people big time. Yeah.
But I guess,
yeah.
It's interesting. Buy your way into Comicsgate.
That's kind of what people have done.
It is so funny. I mean, it's such a weird thing and it's like, because, like, you know, like, the other thing is, like, you can do your comic or you can do your webcomic and, you know, you can just kind of keep putting it out and, like, over a few years, like, build, like, an audience, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So that is there. But it's, like, when, like, as artists, you know, and I did, too, because, like, I remember doing, because I started my comic and as a webcomic and I didn't really, you know, think much about it. I was just kind of doing it. And then Comicsgate happened and I was like, oh man, I could finish this up and jump in on this like bandwagon and get money. And it seems like this shortcut, but it's like, it is such a fickle beast.
It's not going to just automatically, you know.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And I don't know. It's kind of funny that we can all be like super real about it now, you know, and, I don't know. I guess it's just like we're all just kind of like over the fucking bullshit, like drama shit and everything. And just like, hey, the reality is we're all just trying to make money. I know that like people in like Comicsgate, there's still that section of people who think like the outrage and shit is real. Well, actually, you know what it is? It's just a bunch of guys trying to sell comics, man.
It's exactly it.
It really is true. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sure they, you know, there'd be people arguing with me right now, but you know, I'm telling you, you're wrong. Sure.
Yeah, they're not here now anyway, so it doesn't
matter. They're not here. They don't listen.
Yeah.
You know, we're no fun to fight with, so they don't even come over here. But.
Yeah, I mean, I guess, but that's definitely true. The drama is a big, you know, selling point for a lot of, you know, people in Comicsgate.
Sure.
It's becoming, you know, I think for a while, a lot of the drama was dying down, so, like, they had to, like, create some by having certain people come back in and, you know, starting up again. And I don't know.
Yeah.
There's always something going on.
Yeah. It seems more dead now, but like I did kind of go over and listen to a few shows because of this whole, you know, Preston Poulter's wife thing.
That's kind of become a thing.
Yeah. And I realized like, oh, well, wait a minute. If you get back in there, they're still, you know, raging like a, you know, storm over there or something.
Yeah.
So.
Isn't like Nasser back and also?
Yeah, Nasser and Mike S. Miller.
Man. Mike S. Miller's back. The Weasel.
he's not really, he doesn't say he's comics gay, but he live streams with Nasser like all the time. So,
oh man,
they're kind of.
I have a funny story about Nasser. I'll just throw it out there. I never would say this before because, you know, the whole comics gay war thing, but now it's just like so stupid. But remember when like everybody in Comicsgate attacked Mindy Wheeler? She was like that girl that was, I don't know what she was. She was just this girl who was like kind of making comics, and she got into it with Nasser while Nasser was still, you know, going on EBS's show and everything. And then like all of fucking Comicsgate like turned against her, and they're like railing and, you know, being all super mean to her on YouTube. And so like one of my early kind of mess ups with Comicsgate was I made a video defending her. And I also want to say though that like defending her was a total mistake because she is nuts. She is completely crazy. And I realize that now. Yeah. And so it's like just seeing what she posts and stuff, I'm like, oh my God, I can't believe I over defended this crazy bat. But anyway.
Yeah.
I shot my mouth off back then, and, you know, it got me some hate and everything. And so one of the things that happened was that Nasser kid had backed the Berserkernaut.
Oh, geez.
And so he, like, sends me this fucking, like, message where he's like, hey, I never got my book, dude, blah, blah, blah. And I guess he's, like, in Australia or something. And I'm like, are you fucking kidding me? You're going to, like, you know, refund me, like, $40 for this goddamn... And I like search through my freaking receipts, you know. I just like going through like all of them looking for like his, because I saved all that shit, you know. And of course, I had fucking sent it, and I found the receipt. I found the tracking number, and I'm like, "Hey, you know, I got you." And I sent him like a photo of the fucking, you know, tracking number or whatever. And then he's like, "Oh, I guess it must have went to my mom's house or some shit." And I just thought, man, that is so two-faced, you know. It's like, I just because I said something that, you know, maybe halfway insulted that kid, he's just like immediately going after my wallet, you know. And this was like months after the book had, you know, funded and been sent and everything, you know. So I don't know, I don't think much of that Nasser kid.
Yeah, I don't know, I don't really know much about him, because like I wasn't really following Comicsgate back when he was in it. Like I you know, I saw him a few times on Ethan's live stream, and the only thing I really remember of him was people just making fun of him like in the chat and stuff. So I don't know.
Yeah. Well, I think that's kind of his claim to fame, is he sort of like the butt of everybody's joke. And
yeah. But like, I did see something though, where like Ethan, like Ethan goes on his live stream and talks to him and stuff, but like he won't promote his book because he doesn't think it's like professional looking enough. So
yeah,
I don't know, whatever. I think that's kind of funny.
yeah, I don't know, it's crazy. So Johannes Vick is making an appearance in the chat.
What's up?
Hey, dude, are you still shadow banned everywhere? Check, give me like a check right if you're shadow banned, and check left if you're not. Let's start talking in code in here. So I don't want to get you in trouble. This is Andy.
Check the campaign.
Uh-oh.
Oh, check the campaign. Uh-oh.
It's sorry, Frank. He's front loading my campaign with with dirty money.
Frank found a suitcase full of cash on his way home from the grocery store. Like, it's your lucky day, Randy.
Boom.
Oh, yeah. Look at that. Wow. Awesome. Was that you? That's awesome, dude. You're super
1500.
Cool. You truly are Indie Gate, Frank. I don't know.
Yes.
I'm about to say.
Yeah.
What does this mean? I retracted my bid. Now don't.
Whoa,
hey, come on now. Don't play with my emotions like that.
There it is.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I guess I'm Indie Gate now.
Yeah, he's Indie Gate.
Let's see. LOF, that Mark guy.
F that market. Who? Wait, who?
I don't know what you're talking about. Hello, F that market.
Zuckerberg?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Screw him. Yeah. Stop fucking picking on Johannes' goddamn internet.
Yeah, Mark Zuckerberg.
Let him post his goddamn.
Yeah, that's what he did. Comics. He stuck all those millions of dollars into that election. And then he shadow banned Johannes Vick. Damn you.
I know. That's what I want to know right now. Who shadow banned him? I want his head. Anyway. Right, now we're just joking with the Johannes.
Yeah, I'm just kidding. I'm sorry. Yeah. I'm so excited about the $1,500.
Yeah.
It's great. Free Vick. Hey, there you go.
I love it. We got to get him on the show again sometime. Mm-hmm. You want to come back on, Johannes, or whatever?
Whatever, however you say it.
We got to say it wrong.
I'm thinking it's
that's how you Johannes. Do. That's how Jeff does things. That's how old Jeff does it.
Come on,
Joe Haynes, get on here.
I like that.
Oh my.
Joe Haynes won't come on. He always has to. He's got a. It's like a planned meeting, so he can like have a escape route in case the internet tries to go after him. He's got mom down.
Where is he at? Was he seen in
No one knows his location.
Whoa. We ain't doxing anybody on this show, Randy. No. Calm down.
I wasn't asking you to address. Like.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah, well.
J-Pan. I don't know what it means.
Yeah.
He is speaking
that, that's a street Spain? Name. J-Pan.
Japan?
I'm calling when he comes back on the show. This rap album. It's J-Pan and Lil Reba.
Oh, man.
Oh. Yeah, I'll bring it up. I'll start rapping again, people. Watch out. That got everybody quiet quick.
I was just waiting for you to bust into it.
Not tonight.
That's
I mean, you did hit $1,500. There is a that unlocked a stretch goal, didn't it? I'm going to hold you to that.
Yeah, it's a trading card. It's not that
big. Trading. Oh, it's like in your view, like trading card. So that means nothing.
No, stretch goal is unlocked. So that's cool.
There it is. It's official.
Yeah.
Nice.
There it is. Duck, duck, go. We know nobody's tracking. Randy there. Booyah, or whoever that was. Jeff.
Hey, you know. One thing they said when I was over there on that Acevedo stream was he was talking about add-ons or something.
Yeah.
In the did you set that up? Because I was like, I don't know what the hell he's even talking about with add-ons. And I got my PayPal. I almost typed my damn fucking.
Yeah, I know. I'm like,
calm down. It's going to be that type of stream, people. It's the doxing stream. Not everyone goes
down.
Oh, God. Right, forever. Later. Holy shit.
Jeff was drunk on that $1,500 there for a Kill Reaver. He'd be like, woo!
I was on that other show for like freaking
everybody had their pencils out.
A little punchy. Anyway.
Sorry.
What was anyway, I was asking about the add-ons.
It's like I don't have any because I didn't really I just want to do the comic and like sell some original art maybe, but like it's basically when you select a perk when you go to like check out, you can add other items on if you want.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I get it. Because they were saying, you know, they kind of were giving me some advice about my campaign, but I was like, man, was that even going? Because I don't remember that, but
yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
But so,
they were doing things different like 12 years ago, Jeff. And
I know. Yeah. God dang it. Then the one guy, he went from 2 to 3 years. I was kind of like okay with like a year and a half to 2 years, which I guess it's been 2 years, but like, man, 30 years, are you kidding me? Gotta be that long. Oh my god. Anyway.
You start spilling beans, man.
I know. Beans
all over that, all over that stream.
I had to justify what I'd been up to, so I was like throwing out me and Jibrin's secret project. What is that? Somebody messaging me?
Is that
my phone?
Uh-oh. It's PayPal.
Yeah. You have had a fraudulent hit on your account. Are you in Dubai, India?
That's my wife with like pertinent information.
Yeah, she's going, get the damn PayPal off the screen, Jeff. What the hell's wrong with you?
Yeah. I don't
think she's save.
It's not like Randy's wife where she's like keeping tabs on my internet presence.
How do you know?
Let's see. Are your backers now getting a trading card? Oh yeah.
Definitely. Yeah, everyone gets a trading card who backed Kill Reaver. So. And going forward, if anyone backs it, you know, they'll get a trading card.
Incognito mode too. Yeah. Yeah. Right. That is really cool.
Let's see here. Did you back the? I mean, obviously you backed the campaign, but did you get a book or?
Who, Frank?
You at least could have got the Kill Reaver one, both books for $25.
And he already backed it like a while ago.
Oh,
so,
did he? Yeah. Oh, dang, man.
Yeah. He's like becoming my number one fan.
That's pretty cool.
He's already Jeff's number one fan, but.
Right. Whoa.
Or actually, he's Anna's number one fan. I shouldn't.
Oh, I was coming in there with Scott
right now. And refresh.
Wait, yeah, he's refunding.
Yeah, right now. As you speak.
I'm just trying to promote Anna.
The Godfather IndieGate.
I gotta know. Do you know the person that took the drawn into the book?
Yeah, I do know him.
What? Are you doing?
He's me. No, he's actually, it is a friend of mine. It's a tattoo client of mine. He bought it.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. He like came into the shop. He's like, so I guess I'm going to be in your comic. I'm like, okay, awesome.
That's cool.
How do you want to die?
How much was that die in the book one?
I can't remember. I think it was
$300.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah,
I'm not drawn. I'm looking at the campaign of Kill Reaver.
And then, do they have? Did you have? Do you have original art in there then?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, like a page. There's like pages. Yeah,
original cover art.
Yeah.
Comic page is $100. Original sketch $75. Kill Reaver number one, both books for $25. Kill Reaver number one line art cover for $15. Kill Reaver number one color cover for $15. And then the featured is the sketch card commission for $75. Bam.
Salazar's is a crystal that she buy the drawing.
No.
She gets killed for free in the book.
Yeah, right? She doesn't have $300.
Well, that was another one when I was over there listening to that thing about Preston's wife.
Oh, geez.
Preston was saying something about like how he doesn't believe like the CG numbers anymore, and like they're donating to themselves or something. But I was like, that is so far-fetched.
That's a theory. Well, I mean, I'm not going to accuse anyone of anything, but that's a theory that's been kicking around for a while now, that like,
really?
That Ethan like takes money from previous campaigns and front loads the new one to get more eyes on it. Because when you have the more money your campaign makes, you're at the top of the search, you know, when people search comics and stuff. And it also just makes it look amazing that they did, you know, 200,000 in one day or whatever, you know, that kind of stuff. It's like, it's all, so there are people who have said that. And I mean, you easily could, I suppose, like, you know, because Indiegogo allows you to make donations and it keeps it anonymous. I think Kickstarter might not let you do that because they, I'm not sure. And I know there's like a loophole with Indiegogo to where you could actually like pull that off. But again, it's like, it's speculation. I don't know.
Yeah.
But I have seen some Indiegogo campaigns, not anything related to like ComicsGate. And I saw there was an Indiegogo campaign for this book called Calico.
Yeah.
And it's like, he's like a cat superhero. And cool. I saw that they were at like 9,000, right?
Yeah.
And I added up like how many people backed like the perks or whatever. And it only added up to like 100 or like $200. And they had $9,000 going. I was like, kind of like, like that's kind of weird. Like, so I think it could be done.
Wow. That is weird.
Yeah.
That's interesting. I guess you gotta have the money from, that's like the only thing is like, if I try to do that, I ain't got no money to front load my damn Indiegogo.
Right.
Need to run an Indiegogo for that.
You're going to take a small business loan.
Yeah, I'm not sure exactly. I think it would be a stupid, well, I don't know, because I mean, maybe it would get people to be like, oh man, this thing's making, you know, $50,000. I want to get in on it, you know, but then you're putting your own money into something where Indiegogo is going to take a cut of it. So it's like, you're wasting your own money if you do that, you know?
Yeah.
So it's kind of, I think it's kind of, I think it's just bullshit that people are trying to come up with to make, you know, look bad, but
yeah, make them look like they're not successful. Yeah. That makes sense.
Yeah. It's like, I don't think Ethan's putting, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars into his own campaigns. I mean, that would be ridiculous.
Yeah.
But he did back that Liam Gray's Xenotype. Yeah. Like Ethan backed it like 10 times or something like that. So,
oh my God. Aren't those two like warring now or something too?
Well, yeah. He like, I guess, because Nasser came back. So Liam was upset and he copyright struck some videos of Nasser's that were talking about Liam. Ethan like and Ethan said he wanted to refund everything that he gave him, and
oh god,
he wouldn't. I don't know, it's like there is some drama going on there.
Yeah. Good old ComicsGate.
Yeah.
Another day in the life. Giannis Bix says that cover is dope. I love it. Hell yeah, man. It is a really cool cover. I'm digging it. ComicsGate can join IndieGate, but they need to pay fees.
Membership fees. I like
that. Says the godfather of IndieGate right there.
Oh boy.
Word is law.
There it is. Word is bound.
Nate says they do money laundering and are secretly drug dealers. That's why people make so much. Oh wow, that's a great fucking, I can't even believe you came up with that, dude. I mean, but yeah, we need to like pass that to the SJWs. That's like a great theory, right?
Wait, hold on, let me write this down. Okay, got it.
Yeah, makes total sense.
Yeah,
call the comic book cut right now. Let's get him in on that.
I haven't seen that guy in a while. Does he still make videos?
I know. I haven't seen him forever either. He was so like nutty that like I don't know. It just got to the point where I was like, this is my girlfriend.
It's entertaining though. Like I watched his videos a lot, and then like all for some reason they stopped showing up in my. Maybe he's been shadow banned. I don't know.
Ooh, shadow banned.
Stopped showing up in my recommendations.
Yeah.
Comic book.
Yeah.
Comic book. Okay. Yeah.
You remember him, the guy with the little mask, like the Lone Ranger mask or whatever? I know that picture of him cracked me up.
The guy whose New York accent is stronger than Peter Palmiotti's.
Oh, yeah. Johannes Vick says, Nate, you are not wrong. Salazar says, I'll go tell Mindy Wheeler about the money laundering. Ooh. Don't anybody go.
We're just joking.
We're just joking around.
I wouldn't accuse anyone of actually doing that. I think that's people just trying to come up with, you know, dirt on ComicsGate. Is like, oh, they're just, it's a pyramid scheme. They're just backing their own books. Like, come on, man. There's enough people that are actually backing the stuff. Like, you know,
sure.
It's like, come on. I don't know. That's crazy.
No, it's like they, like the anti whoever, I'm not even gonna say they're SJWs. I just think they're the anti-ComicsGate. They want some reason that they're actually failing. You know, they don't like the fact that they're somehow winning. And, that's just a new theory that fits into that, I think, you know.
Yeah. You know, Ethan offered to put $50,000 into Kill Reaver, but I said no.
I'm gonna do it the right way. No, all your cocaine money.
Yeah. Good man, Randy. Good man. Yeah. Randy got principles. Yeah. Me, on the other hand. Bring it on, Ethan.
Bring it on. Yo, I can tell stories, Vic.
Oh, he was kind of serious about the money laundering and drug dealing.
Seems like a possibility for sure. Yeah, I don't know. Are those guys drug dealers though? I mean, like, no. Really, when you, yeah. You know,
I don't run with the devil.
Like, actual drug dealers don't go on YouTube. No, they're not.
And then, you know what? You think about it. Like, what a place to try to launder money. Let's just do it, like, in front of everyone. In front of
everybody, yeah. They'll never suspect us filming it.
Yeah.
These idiots just produced all the evidence themselves and uploaded it to YouTube.
Yeah, then we'll also get like a million enemies against us.
Right. No. See, the joke with that is we'd all go to federal prison and we'd have like two views and like five subscribers or something. It'd be horrible.
Yeah.
So let's make that happen. Hell no. It's gonna be like, it's gonna be Breaking Bad on YouTube in real life. Setting the cameras up tomorrow, people. It's on.
I like it.
It's gonna be Breaking Bad meets The Tiger King.
Oh man, I want to watch that one.
There it is. I've already got people coming. Let's go ahead and set this YouTube channel up.
I know.
Straight to a Gmail. Get myself an email.
When are they gonna get Tiger King out? For God's sake.
I don't know, man. That's what we need to do. We need to GoFundMe for. I don't even know his real name. It's Tiger King.
Yeah,
change his name, Tiger King.
That's like the one thing Trump should do before he's like out of here. He needs to fucking, you know, pardon the Tiger King, and then redeem himself by letting the Tiger King out. Because like, I need some TV to watch this fucking year. I mean, you see like the Masked Dancers on next. I mean, come on, dude. I need some fucking shows to watch.
Yeah. Well, I was thinking we need to launch the Statue of Liberty into space.
That'd be cool.
Yeah.
It's like a cyberpunk rocket ship.
It'd be like the Starship Enterprise, but cooler. Think about it. Think about it.
Yeah, we got to get off this planet before it dies.
Oh, yeah, man. Before Biden takes off. All right. Just
kidding. That is a good idea. We could, like, land on Mars. Well, where would we land, though? We need, like, a planet where we can battle Earth.
We're going straight to the sun, people. The suicide mission. y'all ain't never heard about that there is a, what is it, like a wormhole right in front of the sun. And right before you hit it, man, we're just going to zip off into another dimension. Like the
Beast Tiger King. Yeah.
Another dimension.
Is there a Tiger King comic that will fund his release? I'll contact my people. Oh, that'd be awesome. But
there is a Tiger King. Somebody is doing a Tiger King comic.
Are you kidding me?
It's out there. I saw it.
You know what's weird about that? I wonder if that's like violating like some laws. Because you know how like the serial killers can't write books about themselves and stuff? I mean, of course, maybe it's not about themselves, I guess.
maybe somebody else is just doing it.
Yeah, somebody else.
I wonder if he's like paying like money to use the likenesses, or he's just straight ripping it off. You know, he needs to go to more like a Glanzig type environment.
Yeah.
Where he's like, you know, biting, but a little bit away from it. The Tiger Prince. that's Frank. Frank got that one.
There needs to be a an Artcast comic with like Danzig fighting like Sasquatch or Bigfoot.
Oh man!
you give life a minute.
Okay. get Simon Bisley to do the cover too.
Now it's on.
I'd love that.
All right, I'm down.
Sounds good. For that. I'd love to art direct Bisley. Oh no!
Did you
know?
Oh, yeah.
More
arms look like that.
It's like fucking demons and shit. He'd get along, man, because I'd be able to, I'd just, like talking to Danzig.
And if you called him Danzig, you wouldn't get sued. I mean,
yeah. I know.
Maybe I don't know.
It's called Infamous Tiger King. Look, I'm gonna pull this crap up right now.
Really? Holy shit! Yeah,
there's a book, dude. A comic book.
Tiger Prince lives, man. Hang on to your hats there.
I'm sure that guy. Who's that one guy that does all those autobiographical comics? I'm sure he'll probably do a Tiger King. It's like Blue Water Comics or something like that.
Oh yeah. Well, I thought of that, but then I thought, well, he's talking about a guy. I think that's but you're right. I think that company is just like one guy.
Yeah. I think it is just one guy.
Yeah.
I did some covers for that company. Like I drew them, and like they never paid me. They never published them, but they never they're like, yeah, we're gonna use them, and then like, it was like you know like politicians. Like I did one of what was that guy. Pete Buttigieg, and then the presidential candidate, and then they like came out with the book, and they used like somebody else's cover. I was pissed, but
oh wow!
Yeah. And I did a couple other ones, but they haven't seen public, haven't been published. I don't even care about getting paid. I just wanted to, you know, see them get printed, just to have. But
do like a damn cover, and they don't even use it. How fucking lame!
Yeah, well, you know. It happens.
Yeah.
But
I did one for them. I can't remember what it was. It was Adam West. It was like for their Adam West comic.
And I remember that. Yeah.
And it was cheap though. I remember taking it and then I just couldn't go on.
Yeah.
Like it was like so I don't even remember what it was, but it was like no money hardly.
Yeah, they're like he's notorious for that company. Like
Indiegate rule number one, get the money up front.
I like it.
Words to live by. I love it.
Yes.
Yeah, we need an Indiegate rule book like the Ferengis have. You know? Rule of acquisition number 28 or whatever.
They like the commandments. You gotta know those bitches.
That's right. Oh my god. We ever have a highlight reel, Jim, that's going on it. It's like the commandments. You got to know those bitches.
Amen.
Yeah.
All right. You see why my wife doesn't take me to church?
Did you find the Tiger Prince or whatever?
Oh, yeah, I found it. I'm, yeah, y'all can look it up. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, here. Let me pull it up.
So is it a real thing that's happening like right now?
Tidal Wave Productions.
Tiger King. Yeah, that's the same guy. He changed his company's name. Yeah.
Oh, you're kidding me. Really?
Yeah that
oh,
is.
Oh, wow. Getting of in course. On Comic Gate.
I don't know if he's crowdfunding these or what. I haven't seen that.
Oh, it's just...
I don't think he crowd... I think he just like sells them to... You like honestly,
Amazon.
Yeah, they're on. I never see them in comic book stores, so I think they're just like on Amazon or you know, he like goes to conventions when there were conventions,
yeah,
and sells them.
Yeah, That's interesting.
Yeah, but here, let me share. Share my screen.
Okay.
That's right now. Bam. Let me know. I'll scroll.
Oh, wow. I kind of like the cartoony. Yeah.
There's other ones that are different too. Like, here, I'll find another one in a second. But yeah, Chapter One, Joe Exotic. There it is.
Oh, God.
Damn.
Oh, my God. Yeah, that is
hilarious. Uh-oh. Jeez. What's going on here? This is getting kind of scary.
Wow. That is.
I think that's a good time to end this story.
Yeah. Wow.
I'm fair.
Thank God the next page wasn't up.
Yeah, I don't want the next page. I'm not buying that son of a bitch.
Did he? I don't know. I kind of want to know his backstory now, though. Maybe not. I don't know.
Yeah, well, I don't know. What's going on with this tiger? It's famous.
Oh, wait, hang on. Let's stop sharing. Let me bring her back.
Oh, you son of a bitch. Never mind. That's all it is. It's the same thing. She's got a different cover. Don't bring me back.
Oh, the Tiger King.
Wow.
Get it?
Mm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. There we go. Gone now forever. All right.
It's fine. Is that Jesse, dude?
I don't know. Jesse, dude. Juicy Smollett?
Does he have a comic?
He needs one. How do you say his name?
I think it's Jesse Smollett.
Jesse Smollett?
Yeah, I think. I don't know.
Juicy Smollett.
I like Juicy Smollett much better.
Smollett, bro. That's like elegant and shit. Yes. You say that with your pinky out. It's like fine wine, Juicy Smollett. That's French.
Yeah. That was a good show, man.
What? Which show?
Tiger King. Sorry.
Oh, yeah, it's okay.
I didn't know if you were talking about Empire.
I don't see Jeff as an Empire fan.
No. I don't
watch it. Yeah.
Never know what I'm watching now, that's for sure.
Oh yeah, was that a threat?
No.
You never know what I'm watching.
Yeah.
Whoa, okay.
Apparently you're watching The Masked Dancer. Is that what you were saying?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Is that on yet?
It's not on yet.
How are you going to guess? Like, okay, I watch The Masked Singer with my wife because, you know, she's into it.
Yeah, I know. And that's why I watch it too.
And I can understand that show because you can kind of hear people's voice. How are you going to guess someone dancing? Like,
I know.
And the costume. You're not going to know who anyone is. It's stupid.
Yeah. And who are these famous dancers that are going to be dancing on there? You know? Like, carefree.
No.
Wait, actually, this was one that where I had to razz my wife because I saw. I mean, I don't know what it is, but it's kind of like, you know, all these singing contests. So they have like the RuPaul, like drag queen singing contest or something like that. So it's like have you seen the commercial for this where it's like. It's like American Idol, but for like drag queens.
Yeah, I've seen that commercial before.
And that's what I told her. I'm like, "Are you? This is what we're gonna have to watch." And she's like, "I'm not gonna make you watch it." I'm like, "Yes, you are." Like, I'm telling you why, because there's like not a goddamn thing on, and that's why we watch all these stupid shows. You know?
Yeah, seriously.
Because it's like that, or you know, watch the cooking shows on PBS or something.
Yeah.
A million, CSI episodes or something.
Have y'all seen that Swamp Thing? That new Swamp Thing show?
No, is that I haven't
good. Even. I sent you a link one night, Jeff, but I guess
I ignored it.
Yeah, like everything else. Like everything else. But yeah, It's I can. It's like free. I think it's free on the CW, like the CW.com or whatever.
That's cool.
And they're there.
Watch is it a, is it any good? We need Pete in here to tell us because you know Pete's watching it.
Oh, Pete's watching it.
Yeah.
And then watch the show.
Did you watch Vision Quest? It says Salazar. Yeah. Did you watch Vision Quest, Jim?
Yeah. No, I watched the. I thought it was called. I thought it was called Brokeback Mountain. That's not.
Stop.
Brokeback.
Not that kind of Western, buddy.
I don't know, man. You show up a couple of them scenes, they were kind of snuggled up pretty hard, I thought.
Well, yeah, that is that kind of Western. That's the kind of Western I like. Oh, man.
Or am I?
I'm going to start the masked artist show.
Oh, God. He already did.
Yeah.
Y'all already wear goggles and masks and stuff on your show. You're there, bro. You're there. You've made it.
Yeah. So Vic says, did you guys watch Stargirl? Have you guys watched Stargirl?
Mm-mm. No. I've seen bits of it, but no, I don't. I haven't really watched any of the DC. I've heard they're great, but like I never really got in. I tried to watch Arrow, and like it was okay, but like,
yeah,
I don't know. I haven't really gotten into them, but I'm more of a Marvel guy anyway. I always have been, so I don't know.
DC sucks.
I don't know. Swamp Thing was good. I liked it. I mean, I haven't finished them. There's like one or two more. I think I still need to see. I hope they. I don't know if they're going to keep making them though. I think they're already done.
Oh yeah, yeah. You did share that link with me. Yeah, it's like you got a little picture here or something. I guess I just forgot about it.
The episodes are there for free. I'm going to actually put that in the thing right now. So
yeah, let's give them some promotion.
Well, I'm going to. People can go watch some things. They're decent, man. Let's see here.
Yeah, that's cool.
The CW shows. Just go there and you can watch stuff, man. I'll put it in the chat. Boom. Here. And that Swamp Thing's in there. Bam. There you go.
Yeah.
You're welcome, CW. Your homework,
guys.
Riding our back like this.
So Nate says, Gotham was good for the first few seasons, but then it went downhill fast. I watched a few episodes of that. I liked the ones I saw.
I watched some of it. I don't know. For me, it's weird because like I don't really like it when it's like too different than the comic books. Like it kind of takes me out of it a little bit. But and that's kind of how Gotham was with for me. It was like, well, everything's different, you know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I was just like, what the hell is this? 90210? What the hell are we watching? And my wife's like, this is Gotham. I was like, uh-uh. And that's when I
exactly
off the stand and walked out the room.
Well, it had that a little bit like a film noir or whatever you call that feel for a little bit, which I liked. I don't know. Where did I wanted to see there's a Blue Demon guy in Swamp Thing.
Blue Demon.
Blue Demon the wrestler.
Oh, Blue Devil or Blue Demon? Because there's a DC character, Blue Devil.
Yeah.
And then there's the Demon, Etrigan, the Demon. I don't know. I'm confused.
Made it that far.
There is Blue Demon the rest the Mexican luchador.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Santo.
Yeah, El Santo and the Blue Demon. Yeah.
Yay,
yeah, Vic says it's on CW and it's good or better than Gotham. I guess Stargirl? Is that what he's talking about?
Yeah.
Nate says I think it's Blue Devil.
Yeah, Blue Devil.
Hmm. Yeah. I don't know. I haven't been watching a lot of shows lately. I'm like always on here talking to children.
Yeah, you know, wasting your time. That's what I did. Running my mouth.
Oh man, which is good.
I think like there's so much stuff out now that like, if this was like 20 years ago, I would have been like all over all these DC shows and stuff. But it's like now there's been so many things based on comic books that it's like, I can't keep up with all of them. You know, it's like there's too much. Like, that's just how I feel about it. It's like
I don't know.
But you know, when Killreaver gets a Netflix deal, then I'll get excited.
That's right. We're gonna be all over it again.
I don't know, but then when one comes out that I'm like I had an interest in when I was young, like Swamp Thing, or you know, it's like,
yeah, that's pretty cool. I
have to watch those.
Yeah,
Doom Patrol. Yeah, somebody just put that in there. Is that Kurt Lou?
I never watched it, but
I'm gonna see Doom Patrol.
Yeah, was it good though? I mean,
I haven't seen it. I want to see it.
Yeah,
there's Teen Titans too, right? Are they doing that?
That's what he says.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, they've done everything. They've done the Flash. There's Supergirl. There's been a bunch of other DC shows. It's like, you know, I think there's just like too many to keep up. I might go back and watch them now that like a lot of them are done with, you know.
Yeah.
That's a little easier to catch up.
Well, the ones I liked were like the Daredevil one. I haven't seen Doom Patrol. It looked neat, but I just never found it or thought to find it. But I liked Daredevil a lot, you know. And then what other one was like pretty good? Oh, the Punisher, I guess.
Punisher
was good. I don't know. I also liked, what was it? Luke Cage was good.
Yeah.
What was another one that was good? So I was that one. I watched that one even with the girl. I can't think of what it's called, Jessica Jones or whatever. It was those were fine. The only one I couldn't really get into is Iron Fist or whatever his name is. Oh, yeah. Chakra. Dude, I'm like totally like a Kung Fu master and shit, bro. No, I'm not going to cut it.
Yeah, I didn't. I thought that was bad casting on their part. I don't know.
Just not digging it.
Mm-hmm.
But you know. Give me a Lobo movie.
Yeah.
Lobo.
They've talked about doing Lobo, but like I don't know.
They had Lobo on the
Supergirl
or something. You were showing me that, Jeff. Remember?
Yeah.
Superman shows. I think they had Lobo for a second.
That's true, yeah.
They try to play him out nowadays as Superman's a villain. But man, Lobo's not a villain. Lobo's an anti-hero.
Yeah.
They don't understand what anti-heroes are anymore. Now they're like, "Oh, those are bad guys."
If a villain becomes popular, like an anti-hero type of character, they just totally make them a hero instead. Like Venom, you know, they did that with Venom. Basically, they've done that with Punisher. They just make them like, you know, like even Wolverine. They've totally weakened that character. Like,
oh man,
it's terrible.
Weakened, huh?
Well, yeah. I'm not gonna go there.
But, how did they screw that one up? I mean, that was like the most popular character for like years.
Yeah, he's like he's like one of my favorite characters. But
absolutely.
Now I don't know. I don't know. But I don't. There's like I read very few Marvel books anymore. I'll buy certain artists that I like. Yeah. I don't really follow. I don't buy any title religiously, you know, like every month or whatever. But I don't even know what's going on in half the comics anymore.
Yeah.
Nor do I really want to.
Yeah, that's how I am. I'm like, I don't really care. It's almost like I feel like Marvel and them have sucked for so long anyway. It's like, what's the difference what they're doing with these characters?
Yeah.
True.
Superman is coming. Kirk Lou said that. Hey, Kirk Lou, how's it going, man?
Superman is coming, huh? Another Superman. New Superman? Are they starting over again or what?
Like a TV show?
Oh, apparently. God.
Yeah.
It sounds like maybe TV show. But...
That doesn't surprise me. They've always kind of had, you know, a Superman TV show at, you know, they had Smallville for so long, and, you know.
Yeah, that's true.
Supergirl.
What'd you say?
The old black and white Superman TV show.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
George Reeves.
I like that one.
Yeah.
Remember the one, like, this is the episode that always pops in my mind. Like, I know I watched all the other episodes, but, like, this one always pops in my mind. It's the little midget aliens. Do you remember those guys? And they come, like, popping out of, like, a pipe. Oh. And they're dressed kind of like these robot-looking guys. Do you remember that, Jim?
No, I don't remember that
episode. That sounds very familiar, yeah. I think I can remember that.
I need that one in my life, apparently.
YouTube, here we go.
Yeah.
Copyright infringement.
I got copyright struck on the last stream, too. So thanks a lot.
Everyone, dude. It's just non-stop. It's the thing now, babe.
I know. Like, I don't think I've had, like, one monetized for, like, freaking 2 weeks.
Yeah. Just so y'all know, guys, yeah, the shows are so great that YouTube just, like, either demonetizes them or takes them down.
Oh, yeah, that's I don't mind them demonetized. I hate when they take them down.
So, y'all know that.
So, like, what would I would search for that? 1950s? Midget? Aliens? I have no idea.
What's this say here? It says home. Was it Homebody Lifestyle? Randy, you ever get told you look like Brian Posehn?
Yeah, all the time. when I have my hat on, yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
All right, because you're getting it now. The rest of the show, we're gonna call you Brian.
Yeah.
All right.
That's okay. Yeah. He's a funny guy.
Yeah. The other one I remember of, I forgot about this. It's not the one I'm thinking of, but you guys remember this one? Hang on a second. It's back up. Now I want you to think about this as a parent.
Uh-oh.
Randy.
What?
Hang on.
Ryan.
Let me slow it up. So the next time you go check on your kids.
Oh, geez.
This could possibly happen.
Oh, God.
No!
That's right. That's me, though. That's me. That's me. Just blast. Yeah. I'll be sure.
Yeah.
Oh, that was nice.
Oh, God. Did she throw him out the window?
Yeah, I got
low. I don't know.
Yeah, that was fucking horrible.
It must be cutting some stuff. Hang on.
That was a fucking drastic cut there, dude.
Were they just like little kids with bald wigs on? Like,
yeah. Do you want me to bring it back? Oh, wait.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That lady's expression. That lady's like, she like, yeah.
Somebody watched that movie and then they made ET from that. Right there.
Oh, yeah.
That one on the left. Wow. That one on the left, man.
Holy.
These are the wee Gargamel.
Oh, no. Chase your dad with a dog?
Oh, man. That's right.
I know. I love how, like, so many of these old TV shows, you know what I mean? It was just, like, totally, like, the sound of Gunsmoke. Just, you know, anytime they leave the city, it's immediately like Gunsmoke, you know?
Hell, yeah.
So good.
Yep, that's right. I'm going to punch you in the belly there. Get out of my way. Superman. It's
like decking everybody. From melee with Superman in the middle.
Yeah, Superman's beating people up. He's a bully.
But what would I don't want to search, man. Superman, I can't find the one with the little. I mean, I don't know how to top one I just saw, but.
Yeah, I don't know, man. Yeah, those little Eddie monsters running around or whatever.
I know. They're
crazy little Gargamels.
It was kind of in the same kind of realm, though.
Yeah, what the hell? Were those leprechauns, man? I'm confused, Jeff.
I don't know what they were.
Yeah, man.
I think those might be aliens also.
Right. Those kids have propecia or something, man. I'm confused. What's that stuff called where you lose your hair?
Alopecia.
Alopecia, there it is. Those kids had alopecia. How dare you get those children?
Oh, God. Have you ever seen the the episode of I Love Lucy with the like Martians, and they're like little midget guys. That's a good one.
That is totally good. And there was a Superman episode, I Love Lucy, also. Remember that?
Yeah, that's a great one. Yeah.
I think he comes for like little Ricky's birthday party or something.
Like Lucy's in a Superman, like dressed up as Superman. She's like stuck out on the ledge, and he like jumps out to save her. It's like, so fake.
That was a great one, man. Oh yeah, wow, they got a color version of this? Oh, they just had a black and white TV show, TV at the time. I don't remember this being in color for sure.
Let's
add out of here. Yeah, we know. We all have coronaviruses.
Yeah, I don't remember. Yeah, I don't remember that in color.
That's got to be colorized, though.
Yeah, it's black and white for sure.
Let's see. Oh, yeah, here we go. This is kind of.
Yeah.
That was great. That
bootleg Superman costume she's wearing.
Yeah,
it's like go off, and then he like did. Yeah. Like, you're not fooling anybody.
What's that guy wearing on his head?
That's a party hat. That's
a party hat.
Yeah,
what kind of party they have.
No, it's not 1950s. You know this.
Yeah,
look at that.
It needs me one of those. They got a monkey. I don't know. It's a kid. Damn it.
I thought they had a little monkey. Oh, is that a little sticking there, bro?
Yeah.
Is that him? That's not him.
Oh, wow.
Kid, yeah.
Yeah, that's him. Yeah, he looked like a monkey.
Yeah, oh, that's funny.
One of those, like, organ grinder monkeys, you know, like the.
Hell yeah. Are you trying to do that, kid, Randy?
Wait, what now?
Yeah, exactly. Organ grinder. Delete that.
Look it up. It's a thing. All right.
Can I edit this?
Not that kind of organ.
I can't find that Superman thing with those. I have to like go through some episodes of him.
Oh, don't worry, dude. Yeah. So it wasn't. I thought. You could have lied and just said it was those fucking.
I know.
Kids, dude. I'd have believed you. I'm like, no. Look at that. That's crazy looking.
I think part of it's like every time I type in like Superman without like 1950s, it pulls up like a billion like Superman cartoons and stuff. So. Yeah,
those old school cartoons were there.
Oh yeah, they were cool.
Oh, those were actually good. Here's one right here.
Robots and the train and all that stuff.
Yeah, mad scientist. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's where when they were putting some time and money into kids' cartoons.
Yeah, how did we get on this Superman kick?
Who did that? Oh, totally you lost.
You bringing up Swamp Thing?
It was Kirk Lou, I think. Yeah, Kirk Lou said Superman's coming.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, these are what's up, dude. Yeah. Oh my god,
yeah, they're so good.
Better than most, you know, any cartoon nowadays.
I know.
It's like most, but all of them.
Yeah,
they're almost like this Disney animation.
Cartoon Network.
Woo, just in time. Cool. They actually had a
$1 million limit running wild.
There he goes.
Oh, the train's getting wild on that train again.
I know. Look how good this is, though.
It's crazy.
It really is. Like the shadows, all the painted backgrounds and stuff. Yeah, and like, so wow.
Good. So good.
Yeah. No CGI After Effects tricks on this sucker, huh?
Man. Look at that guy.
Uh-oh. Right into the danger explosives train. Got all right, Superman. Another great cartoon, like that, I think these same guys did, was like the Popeye cartoons. Did you guys ever see those?
Yeah.
Yeah. Those are really awesome too.
The Fleischer brothers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, all right. Let's get this off here before we're gonna finish the hour. Channel goes down.
Yeah, forever.
Yeah, Kirk Lee says, I love the Fleischer ones. Mm-hmm. Lois Lane is always getting into mischief. Right. Hell yeah.
That's what a woman do.
Kurt Lee says they use rotoscoping. They probably did somewhat. Or digital art.
Right. I want to see more of that. People get to work. Produce some of that good stuff.
Well, yeah, I know.
They brought that, you know, in the 90s when they brought the Batman in, you know, and they started doing Batman in that kind of time period. It definitely had that feel to it, you know.
I agree. I think, like, they were kind of trying to do something, you know, like that with the first Batman cartoons.
Mm-hmm.
And they were good, too. I thought they were really good.
They didn't look as good as what we were just looking at there, though, man. That stuff
is no.
No.
But I like them all. I even like the 60s Marvel ones that are just pretty much like the cut-up comic books and stuff, you know?
Yeah.
I thought those were neat, too. And I don't know. So
did you feel betrayed by the live-action Adam West Batman, Jeff?
No, I liked it. I thought it was all about Batman when I was a kid. And that was funny.
I feel like people are like, oh, I hated it. What? I love that shit.
The live-action Batman, they didn't like it?
Yeah, I had a bunch of friends that did not like it. It was all campy like that.
Oh. Well, I think as a kid, it didn't matter to me because I was like a really young kid when I saw that. Oh, so.
Yeah. Well, me too. But
yeah.
Some of my friends didn't like it. But I loved it.
I mean, I guess if you were like reading, you know, Frank Miller's Dark Knight and then you watching the reruns of that show, you'd be like, what the hell? You know?
Yeah. But I actually like those nowadays, like, you know, because they have some on the rerun kind of channel or whatever you call it on Saturdays. And I get a kick out of them.
Oh, yeah.
So, Vincent Price is Egghead.
Yeah.
Well, I like the like, you know, the way they do the little, what is it called? The scenes and stuff. How they have it all painted up and really artistic and fun. All the outfits.
Yeah. Yeah, everything's like kind of like this over the top, like 60s. Funny. I don't know.
Car culture is all immersed in it.
Yeah.
Cool. It's the same thing with like the Munsters and all that stuff. It's kind of like car culture all immersed in it. I love it.
Yeah, you talking about I don't know, kind of like the 50 surf movies and stuff also kind of had that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like all that stuff, man.
Yeah. I loved all those movies too. Like those were so corny, like when I watch them nowadays, but back in the day I thought they were great. I don't know. But that's all like the rerun stuff that like I grew up on, you know, like on Saturdays and stuff. That's what they would show on like TV, you know. And so I really like, there's like a lot of nostalgia for that stuff to me.
Speaking of those surf movies, it was, I should get it out. It was Annette Funicello and what was his name? That guy was in those movies. It was those surfing movies. You know what I'm talking about? No?
No, yeah, I know what you're talking about. Yeah. The guy with the black hair that was always with her.
Yeah, I can't think
of his name. God, I can't remember. I'm trying to remember without searching it.
Is that it?
Frankie Avalon.
Frankie Avalon?
That's right.
Frank said that in the chat, not me. I got it off of Frank.
Frank, you're the beautiful.
That's because Frank's named after him.
Yeah.
Frankie Avalon. Nice. Is that true, Frank? I want a confirmation if it is.
Just say yes.
I thought he was... named after Frank Miller.
No, Frank Miller, yeah.
He's probably named after St. Francis.
Ooh, that's big.
Just.
Yeah, what we went hard there, Randy.
Well, you know, I know a thing or two about religion. Yeah. Not really.
And that was about it.
No, he was named after Frankie Avalon. He said yes.
Yeah. Frank would claim Frank. I know Frank. So what's Kel Reaver up to? We haven't checked.
It is. Oh, man. Beat it up. Beat it up. Come on. Another 25. Another 25. 25. No.
Come on, people. Where are you at?
Everybody, go spread the link, like, on your social media.
Yeah. Go to your social media right now and blast that link. You got 2 hours left. See if we can get somebody to jump on it. See if we can move the Ombre.
$1,500.
Name is Jesus. So it's Francisco Jesus Salazar.
It's Jesus.
It's not Jesus.
It is? What?
Jesus.
His middle name is Jesus.
It's kind of weird. It's kind of weird though, like how Spanish and Mexican culture, they're like the only people that name like their like kids after Jesus directly. Like you don't get a like, you know, like there's not, you know, it's like it's kind of a strange thing. Like,
yeah,
I don't know, something I just noticed. Like, you know, I don't know that many white kids named Jesus, you know what I mean?
No, so, you're right.
Basically throw it out there.
It's a little too much of a hard flex, I guess.
Maybe, yeah. It'd be kind of cool, but no, yeah. But Jesus, yeah. You know, there's tons of people named Jesus.
Well, how come, yeah, that's weird. I mean, because they name kids after all the other, like, saints and stuff, Peter, Paul.
Yeah, sure, you know, yeah.
All that. That's super common. But then they, yeah, how come they didn't just add Jesus in there? I don't know.
Man. No Lucifer's either, I noticed.
Lucifer's? Well, I know there's that one. Hangs out with Russ all the time. Isn't he named Lucifer or something?
Oh, yeah, but I don't think he's real. He's Lucifer.
Oh, his parents didn't name him that.
You just wait. Kids nowadays, wait till these names start popping up.
What? You're getting like low, Jim. I can't quite hear you, dude. Are you like straying from the mic?
He's slowly sinking into hell.
Oh, man.
Is that better?
Yes. Oh, yeah. There we go. Yay. Now we got Jim.
Yay.
Now we got some Jib going.
We're getting the whole family tree here. My mother's first name is Maria. My dad was
I thought Maria. Frank's middle name was Ringo.
Ringo, right? Well, we messed that up.
Dang it.
Jose de Jesus before he legally changed it to Jesse. James.
Jesus. Legally changed it to Jesse. Hmm. Interesting.
Huh.
All right.
Jesse cool. James.
Thanks, Frank.
Now that Frank's doxed his whole family.
Okay, now if you can get us their social security numbers.
Yeah.
What's your mom's maiden name?
Yeah, bring us some data, please. Mailing addresses. You're gonna go ahead and get Kel Reaver up here. Donate to a good cause, I promise.
I'll send them all copies if they.
Yeah, they're getting copies, dude. It's all good. It's not theft. They're just buying something. 'Tis the season.
Frank's mother just gets a random Kel Reaver in the mail.
Yeah. It's horrible. She's like, oh man, I can't even do it. It's horrible. It's horrible.
I don't even know what you want to say.
Yeah, I can't even get it out.
Just don't.
Yeah. You'd hear her calling Frank, freaking out about the Kill Reaver book showing up in the mail.
I
said, yes,
Ideal's meal.
Yeah, dude. As soon as she opens it, yeah, she throws it right in the trash and runs and gets the Bible and starts praying, dude. No, no, you can see it. Bring the demon, brought the devil into the house.
Pretty much.
Yeah. Yo, Abe.
That's horrible. How dare y'all?
Yeah, that's not right.
Stream's over. Turn it off.
Yeah, didn't Marshall make a stream about devil comics or something? I thought I saw that. Yeah.
Like he's a devil worshiper nowadays.
I was wondering about what he was talking about in that. Maybe watch it.
We're gonna watch it.
Well, I don't want to watch it, but I was just, did anybody watch it? Was what I was going to
ask. No, I didn't watch it.
I was just curious what he's talking about.
It sounds like something I would watch.
I got a feeling he had that Lucifer Storm dude on.
Oh. Well, no, I don't. Yeah.
Well, and then as soon as I said that, Frank popped that up in the chat. Marsh and Lucifer Storm on.
Oh, really? Oh, okay. Yeah. So, is that what the kind of comics that guy makes too, or does he just named after the devil?
No, I think he does. I think it's like something about like it's like I don't forget. It's like his name of his book is like Lady Satan. There it is. Anyway, he's going all out.
He says I saw part of it, but I tuned out. That's right. He stuck his fingers in his ears and he started praying to God.
Wow.
Chanting the rosaries.
Yeah.
Stay away from me.
That's
right, Frank. You just keep
your head down. I walk through the kingdom of the valley. I'm just kidding. He starts laying out the prayers.
Lady Satan. He's doing Lady Satan.
Doing Lady Satan, huh?
That's kind of like Danzig's or Glanzig's character. Didn't he have like a Satan character
too? Yeah. Satanica.
Satanica.
Yeah.
Probably at that time he had you draw. I'm sure it was some girl with goat legs.
Yeah, and the bat things that come off.
But apparently her tits weren't big enough, Jeff. Her
bigger boobs. Yeah. Come on, Lafferty.
Yeah. Let me tell you something, Jeff. You need to make up for some bigger boobs, man.
I would love to like do like a parody of like. You know, Danzig back in the Verotic days, like that he'd actually have like a studio of artists like working under him, and he like would just be like yelling at him and stuff, like Stan Lee, you know, but like just crazy Danzig type of stuff.
Yeah.
I think that'd be pretty funny.
Yeah. Probably.
Little old Danzig.
I liked a lot of those comics though back then. So.
I know them.
Like Jaguar God, I thought was pretty cool.
That was cool. Okay, the thing is, I mentioned it before to Jeff, and he was like, "Look, no, I don't remember that." Do you remember the Verotica book?
Yeah, it was like the anthology.
The one that was like I don't know. There was like a book, and it was like this cross, like this, like demon.
Oh, okay. I don't know. Well, like they had a
demon one.
Yeah. Well, they had a bunch of Verotica. I thought was just like short stories of like.
Is that what it was?
And then they had a bunch of other titles too. But like, yeah, Verotica I think was like each issue had a bunch of different stories in it. I could be wrong though. I don't know.
Yeah, they were wild, man.
Yeah, yeah. There was like a story in one of them I remember where like. I can't even get into it on this.
My question is, how the hell did Glenn Danzig get Frazetta to draw Satanica?
Well,
I know money.
Throwing money at him, yeah.
Yeah, well, he also, you know, well, he did the Death Dealer comic. Yeah. And I think he also, at that time, I think Danzig was like the exclusive, like, art dealer for Frazetta, like for prints and stuff like that too. Like, so I'm sure that that's what it was. He probably made a deal where, like, you know, we'll do all your art prints and stuff and handle all the sales, you know, and just, you know, draw some of my characters or something. I don't know. I'm sure there was something like that.
Yeah, that could be. Yeah. I mean, I know he published that drawing book that he came out with too, mm-hmm. Arcania, and that was right around that same time.
Yeah, he did.
And yeah, so he might have been entrenched in that business.
Yeah, because, you know, Dan, before he started Verotic, he used to go to, he sold original art, and he actually, he would like go to convention. He had like booths at like San Diego Comic-Con, like where he and some of his buddies or whatever, they were like original comic art dealers. So,
oh wow.
Yeah. He was like really into it. Cause there's actually Dan Frega has a funny story about like, he was at San Diego Comic-Con and he wanted to buy like an Arthur Adams piece off of Danzig. And, you know, he had to go get cash from like the ATM. So he's like, you know, just hold this here. I'll be right back. I'm going to go get cash. And then, you know, I'll buy it. And Danzig was like, okay. So he went to get the cash. I guess he came back and he's like, yeah, I'm back for that Arthur Adams piece. And Danzig's like, I sold it. Like, yeah, I guess he got into it with him. Like, I was like, that's an awesome story. You should have like punched him or something. Like,
that's funny.
Yeah, right, I sold it. Beat it, kid.
That's right. I sold it. What an autograph.
What a dick, though.
Hell yeah, bro. He's a dick.
It's too short.
Yeah.
Like picking on the midget.
Well, that one guy that
short to ride this ride.
There was like a guy that punched him and became like super famous from it. Had like a documentary made about him and stuff. Like,
really? Wow.
Yeah.
Dan's getting mouthy backstage, gets knocked out.
Yeah, knocked out by some random dude.
That was like, dude, like easily a foot taller than little old Danzig.
Oh man,
I mean, Danzig's
little dude. He's
wide. He had some muscle. He was like Wolverine, but not as cool. But
I mean, here's the thing, is dude, when you're 5'2",
yeah, you kind of have
and to. The other guy's like damn near 7 foot tall.
Yeah, you could.
Bro,
yeah.
The reach alone, there's a problem. There's a freaking problem going to happen there. Now, I'm not saying Danzig couldn't have got in on him like a rabbit Wolverine. Maybe got on him. Got him or something. But bro. It's not what happened.
Exactly.
I mean, the reach came into play and he got bebopped.
Right. There's small guys that I wouldn't, like some of those little 150 pound MMA guys, I wouldn't want to mess with.
Oh, yeah.
Because they know what they're doing, but
Lansing probably didn't. That's what I was just saying.
But I mean, still, they got to get in on you too, though. Motherfuckers got reach, dude. Just stand back and kind of keep.
But he just got like,
he got that one hit wonder. It was that thing of Danzig like kind of shoved that dude, if I remember correctly, and I was like, fuck, and that dude was instant like, oh no, you put your hands on me, dude, and he just hit Danzig's button. He said, here you go, lights off. Just turn the lights clean off on Danzig. Yeah, let's look that one up.
Do it.
Yeah, I'm getting it out. We're going to watch Danzig get knocked the fuck out. Hold on.
I'm sure it's on YouTube.
Oh, it's all over YouTube. Yeah. So it's just going to say Danzig gets knocked out, I'm sure.
I think it was Glanzig.
That's my boy. My moneymaker.
There it is.
There it is. That's right.
Hey, look at me, man. I'm little old Danzig.
Yeah. Oh, that dude's not, my God. Yeah, he did not fuck around with it. He's like, okay, you want to fight?
Let me lay down. I thought the dude was bigger. Never mind. The dude wasn't that big. He was a fat boy.
He was big.
Get up, Danzig. That was weak. That could have been better.
Where did he go?
Hilarious.
He's laying there.
All the hot hooker chicks laying on there too. Wow.
Yeah. He's laying on the ground going, man, I should have just kept my mouth shut and had sex with one of these girls.
Yeah. No.
Had to pick on the fat dude.
Yeah. He's a big guy.
Boy, likes a punch.
Yeah. He's got some weight, but yeah. Who knows? It didn't even look like he really got him that good, too.
Yeah.
It almost looks like he goes across the top of his head or something.
Yeah, like he just, why does he got to sit down like that? He's like,
oh, no, yeah.
Let me lay down here. Let me take a rest. Right about here. Time for Danzig.
Yeah, he was totally out. Like,
yeah, he's on the ground, bro. He's on the ground thinking about life, thinking about that next album.
Considering
he was calling for his mama.
Yeah, you should have brought mama. Yeah, he was going mama. He was crying for his mama.
That's what I'm gonna call him.
We should have paused it and it'd be like, and this is about the moment where Danzig realized he fucked up.
Well, you're a rock star. I'd imagine like that was probably the last thing that he thought was gonna happen, you know. He probably
pushed his big ass mouth was gonna get in there and get in the middle of it. Right, no man, no.
Exactly. And he's like, what the hell?
Billy Bob gave him some chin music.
I'm just waiting for the day that like Danzig confronts one of us at a convention or something if he sees these videos.
Good, I can only he can come strolling up in his walker, that old son of a bitch.
Guys,
I got a few years on you, Danzig. Nowadays, in your prime, Danzig, you could have got me.
Yeah.
But nowadays, time has caught up with you, son. I got you, boy.
How old is he? Like 60?
Nah, yeah. Is he that old for real? I'm just kind of
being mean. He might be. I mean, I don't know.
The Misfits came out when 79, 80? When the Misfits?
Yeah, he's got to be.
All right. He was already releasing albums. I was barely born.
He was born in 1955, actually.
Yeah, 65. Whoa. Yeah. I can't beat up Danzig now.
Fuck that shit. This is prime time to get him.
I wonder if does he still wear those like skin tight black cutoff shirts?
He's fucking better. He better be wearing leather pants with that big Glenn Danzig belt buckle and no shirt in his old age. I don't give a damn. No shirt, never. That man never wearing a shirt in his life. Him or Henry Rollins should never wear a shirt, ever.
Salazar, I'm sorry I missed this.
Uh-oh.
He says, I looked up Glenn Danzig comic and a homoerotic comic showed up. Henry and Dan.
What the hell?
Dan. Go look that comic up, yeah.
All right. Don't look up. Frank should not look up Glenn Danzig comics.
You are not in the Glenn Danzig comics, dude. This is not where you want to be, Frank. I'm serious. Henry and Dan is some comic somebody made about, I think, Henry Rollins and Glenn Danzig having a love relationship.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah.
And apparently Henry and Glenn.
Yeah, Henry and Glenn.
So it's about, that's weird.
And Dan. I love it, Dan. It's Dan Danzig. It's not about his half brother Dan from another marriage. He's the real evil one. He like kills cats. He's emo. Dan's emo. There you go.
That's it.
Oh wow, I've never seen that. It's like Love and Rockets.
Yeah, I was just looking. They swiped the cover design, and even this chick.
Yeah, it's
this chick. Which chick? Point at the chick.
This one.
Well, yeah, Danzig.
Is that actually him?
I know they drew him a little bit to look like old Robert Smith from The Cure, but yeah, that's apparently Danzig.
Why are Hall and Oates in it?
Yeah,
I know. It looks like Kevin.
I think it's Hall and Oates though. Why is he wearing an upside down cross and a pentagram? It's like, why is Lionel Richie wearing a pentagram? That's what I want to know. What are you doing, Lionel Richie? Why are you doing that to me?
Yeah. Pull up the Love and Rockets cover.
All I know is we're going off the rail on the crazy train tonight.
We are so far fucking
off in the weeds, dude. All good. You had a long night. You had a long day. Jeff has been live streaming now for almost 5 hours.
He's definitely Comicsgate now.
Yeah, Comicsgate.
Yeah, constantly live streaming their whole life.
I know. That's so true.
There it is. Fucking next is EBS, then the world.
Yeah.
Just kidding.
No. I'm not Comics Gate, because if I was Comics Gate, then I could help Randy fund his comic. But
yeah, the old comics.
Rockets cover.
Yeah, straight swipe so, that Glenn Danzig. Yeah, they made him a straight right off a female.
That's funny. That's
funny. I wonder who put that out. I don't ever remember that. I mean, maybe I wasn't paying attention, but I don't know. It's kind of funny.
Good times.
Good times.
Every time you need a favor.
So where is Kill River? What time is it?
It's where is it?
Where is it? Yeah, is it done yet, Randy? Come on, man. No. 2 hours left. The book will be done in 2 hours.
Oh, yeah. We're going to ship them tomorrow. No.
Back now.
Oh, no. I didn't mean where is it. Where can I have it?
Just kidding. Sorry, don't believe me.
Where it was like at money wise.
It's still at 15.
$1,500.
We need
2 hours left.
Yeah.
Just leave that up and we're just gonna badger it the whole time. Right. Yeah, in the chat.
I pulled up all kinds of reference. I don't be dragging stuff across it by accident. what is it? Henry and Glenn forever and ever. Forever and ever. I don't know who those two guys were. It's Nate. That's all right.
The guy's fighting? Danzig and some guy. I don't know.
Yeah. Southside King.
I don't know who it was.
Yeah, it was Glenn Danzig and some dude.
Yeah, and some dude that liked to drink. That apparently could throw some fists.
Oh, man.
You know, glass jaw Danzig taking what some sweet chin music.
Wonder what happened to that guy. Did he get sued for like $10 million?
Probably.
Super lame.
I'm sure Danzig pressed charges against him.
Tried.
Yeah.
When he woke up.
But he did. he did. Danzig shoved him first, though. So.
Yeah, he should have kept
That's
his
true.
Hands. But the thing is, if Big Boy knows his game, which I'm sure he does, by the time Danzig got up, Fat Boy was gone.
Yeah.
They were getting like into their little Toyota Tumbler and getting the fuck out of there.
It looked like there was a big crowd that swarmed in to, you know, make sure.
Oh, that, yeah. The elderly was okay. Yeah.
Yes.
Come to time and a place, you know, and I've hit that point, and I'm that way too. I haven't realized that, you know, as we hit that age, man, you got to slow down.
Oh God, yeah.
Stop killing.
Slow down a little bit. I keep telling myself that, but you know,
I did that a long time ago. Like,
the question is, do you want to burn out or fade away, man? That's the question. Woo! No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah.
But any other famous people been knocked out that we know of? That one YouTuber dude's boxing now. Like Mike Tyson had a boxing match recently. Old ass Mike Tyson. Don't give me an answer. He's like, Mike, come on, man.
Oh, yeah.
Stop fighting people.
Yeah, he's like at least – pushing.
Say 60 again. Let's just keep saying 60 for everybody tonight. 60, everybody's 60 years old tonight.
Yeah, he had a fight with Roy Jones Jr., who's also pretty old, and there must have been a lot of money involved. I don't know why they would be doing that.
Yeah,
it's crazy.
Did you guys? I saw a part of like a little clip of it. Didn't look like there was a hell of a lot of action happening, but.
Yeah, it ended in like a draw or something. So it's like, man.
Yeah.
Edge Sapien said Jake Paul.
Oh, yeah. He wants to fight. Who does he want to fight? I don't even know. Or Logan. Jake Paul or Logan Paul?
Logan Paul.
Maybe. There's two. They're brothers. But yeah, I think he wants to fight that Conor McGregor, maybe.
Brothers should fight each
other. My God.
Something like that. Are you
kidding me? Like a real guy? I don't want to fight anybody.
Yeah.
A real guy?
I'll fight some of these like Comic Day guys, but I ain't getting in the ring with Conor McGregor.
Yeah.
Why would you want to go in and get your bones broken for?
Yeah, I don't know, man.
That's crazy.
It's weird.
Nate says 54. He thinks, I guess Tyson's 54.
I thought he was older. I don't know.
Yeah. He's got that sweet face tattoo.
Or Mayweather. Is that who he wants? Maybe that's who he wants to put Jake Paul. I don't know.
Mayweather, yeah.
Either way, he would get his ass kicked.
Well, who's that other guy? Have you guys ever seen that other dude on the internet that, like, just kind of, like, goes around sucker-punching people?
Oh, God. No, but hold on. Let me write this down. What's his name?
Well,
That's terrible. What? I thought that was like a gang initiation.
I only watch that, you know, when I'm not streaming church, you know.
Yeah.
Sucker punch random people.
Yeah, you know, I like the you watch the sucker punch show? I mean, he's always sucker punching elderly. It's okay.
Like, you know.
This guy, what he does is he kind of lures people into like sparring with him. When they start to spar with him, he like full on just goes to town and beats the hell out of them. And then he has this boxing record that he claims where he's like beat up like 50 guys, but everybody's like not ready for him.
Is it like out on the street or in a gym or how is this?
It'll be like in a gym. It'll be like all these random places. And then, it pulled up the movie Sucker Punch. Sucker Punch Guy, man.
Sucker Punch Guy.
Here he is.
Yeah, and then here he is. This is a video of him fighting, Floyd Mayweather, like, senior or something. And so they go to spar, and then this kid just goes crazy on him. And this is him. I don't remember. I'll look up his name in a minute.
Oh my God.
Charlie, that's his name. I don't know. This isn't even that bad, but there's ones where like guys are like, hey, I'm not gonna. And this is what he does. He like hits him and then he just basically like runs off afterwards. Like anytime he starts to lose, he just takes off running. You know? I don't know. This is a good example. Let me go find another one.
This kid's annoying.
He's a little shit. He's just doing it. See, I was imagining him doing it in like random Walmart parking lot. So I mean, it's a little less seedy than I thought it was gonna be.
Yeah, it's still because
at first I was like, Jesus, Jeff, you're on one CG show and you coming back with sucker punch knockout videos. What the hell?
I thought it
looks a little more legit now that.
There are videos you're like selling it. Charlie Zelenoff sucker punches 66 people at LA Fitness.
That's a great title though, bro. Hold on. Sucker punches 66. How the hell?
This is a compilation. So here we go. We'll see what it looks like different guys. Can I speed this up, maybe?
Isn't it like the middle of like a yoga class? Like there's like somebody stretching back there.
Why is this happening? I'm confused. Know. See, Nate knows about him. He tells people that they are going to do a light sparring, and then he starts really fighting really hard to knock them out.
Maybe we'll get to see. So yeah, he's gonna fight this guy now. Then he just takes off on him and just goes crazy.
Has anybody ever like did people clean his fucking clock?
This guy can kill this kid. Look at this guy.
This guy like looks like he put a weight into this. He might be doing okay.
There is one where Karma comes up and basically finally takes this kid out because he starts to threaten this one like real life boxer someplace and then the guy gets him in the ring and the kid cannot fight. I mean, he just like basically chases him around the ring for a while and he just runs out of the
he probably turns the camera off before he gets his ass kicked, you know.
Yeah. But no, that's like what I mean though. See, it's like always some guy who's like, I don't really want to fight you, you know what I mean?
Abe says, looks like Peter's build.
Abe. Oh God.
It is Peter. What are y'all talking about? This is what Peter does when he's not inking comics. Working at a food truck. Oh, serving up them kitties. He's out, yeah, making these YouTube videos.
All right. So this is the one he fights. He fights this guy wild. Oh,
this dude ain't.
Yeah, this guy's like a real boxer. And this is like after months of him basically. See, he gets him out. They're not even in the ring at this point.
Yeah,
yeah. And if you can hear what he's saying, he's like, all right, you're going to quit or something. And the guy basically just says no. But let's see.
Yeah.
A lot of running around if he ever gets back up.
Where's Kimbo Slice when you need him?
Oh, I know.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, man. Ooh. He's going to lay some hair on you, man. That was a solid punch right there.
Oh, hell yeah, dude. Oh, this dude is fed up with his ass, too.
Yeah, that was you on your...
You know, I don't know. When you actually get into it, it's just kind of like he kind of just deserves like what he's getting at. But eventually, he just runs the hell out of this place.
Cause he's like shit talk. Is he like shit talking him and stuff? Like
he shit talks everybody. Yeah.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Anyway.
Yeah. That's the guy that ended up getting shot in the parking lot and not understand why.
Uh oh.
Peter sees this. I'm just playing.
Right. Make sure. Hey, get some screen captures, guys.
Yes.
Yeah.
Christmas just got good.
Peter Bill.
I am for Christmas.
Sorry. Peter okay. Bill. I know. That was a puzzle.
Yeah, that's a good one, dude. That's a good one, Frank.
Laffy
versus Tyson. Maybe like Tyson chicken sandwich or something.
Yeah.
Jeff might fight a Tyson chicken breast or something on stream. But
yeah, I'll take on some Chick-fil-A right now. Hell yeah. Oh, so are we going to try to – are we going to hit Kill Reaver one more time? Yeah. Come on, Kill Reaver. Right.
Reeve me up.
Whoa. I want an extra 100 off this baby. Come on.
Come on, baby.
Come on.
$10? Oh,
$10. Yeah. We'll take it. We're taking it to the bank. Randy, I need that $10.
I know. So, yeah, Randy's it is funding in like, what, an hour? So, like, if Randy owes you money, give him a call a couple hours, he'll be all right. So
yeah, he'll be straight.
Collect before he spends it.
If you're like with the mortgage company and Randy has been bullshitting you with some them COVID mortgages payments not coming in, he's got you.
Like Ed said, he's gonna be hood rich for about an hour. So
yeah, that's it. So get on him. Get on him before he gets that PlayStation 5.
There you go.
Well, thanks for coming on, Randy. And the thing is you still got $15, and plus it's going to go into demand, and you're making comics now. So, I mean, I just think it's a success, right?
Yeah, definitely. It got funded. I mean, I made my goal, and so everything from here on. Yeah.
That's right. I mean, just think like back in the old days, trying to sell like $1,500 worth of your indie comic had been impossible, you know?
Exactly.
You gotta ask the ultimate question. So do you plan on crowdfunding another comic book, Mr. Randy Siplon?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, I mean, Kill Reaver number 2. Hopefully next year, but I might wait a little bit just because I don't want to launch at the same time I did this one, because I think it was a little too close to like the holidays and stuff. So I might, if I launch Kill Reaver 2 next year, I'd probably do it like during the summer. So, but we'll see, you know, I'm still working on the first one, focusing on that, and then we'll, but yeah, I'll definitely crowdfund again. Yeah.
Cool. Cool.
I think that's a good idea, though, because I kind of think this, you know, especially ending at Christmas. I think it could go through December, but like ending right before Christmas is kind of hard.
Right. Mm-hmm. I might even put Kill Reaver number one on Kickstarter just to see what happens. So
how dare you, Randy?
I know, but whatever.
we're never gonna get over promoting this book. We're just gonna be promoting Kill Reaver for the next.
Well, he's going with that Lafferty. He's got that Lafferty fucking. That like expectation there was like, was it 90 days to the next book? See, yeah. I heard them say that on that other stream. They called you out on that. And the thing with that is what you should have told them is you're talking about government days. It's like about government days. I mean, you know, like 15 days to slow the spread. It's turned into like almost a year. Well, shit, 90 government days, bro. It's like it got to be a couple of years, right? So you're okay. You're doing good.
So wait, were they giving you crap about that or something?
There was a guy who bought the comic and he was like looking through it and he's like, yeah, that's back in here. Oh. You know, it says in 90 days, like, you know, the story continues. He just read it and. But you're right. I should have totally been like, well, that doesn't include like bank holidays and Saturdays and Sundays and all.
Yeah. We're talking work days. And I don't really work.
That's hilarious. Okay. So.
Yeah. It was kind of funny because like, I almost get the impression that, like, because that guy came on later on the stream, but I think like the Acevedo and like, you know, they just sort of had the impression like, that the Berserker Knot was like a new book, you know, or whatever. Somehow they had missed this book.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? And this is like, it's 2 years. And in some ways, I've kind of almost been like, do I even want to do it anymore? You know, it's like, you know, I don't know. At some point.
Well, here's the thing, though. You know, you still have it in demand and you still have copies of it to sell, right?
Sure, yeah.
So it's like, you might as well, because you're going on. His show, you're gonna have a bunch of new people seeing it for the first time. So it's like, you know, whatever. I'm gonna milk this for like a year.
You're right. I could. I'm sure. Like, if I just, that would be the way to go. Is like when I get the second one out.
Sure. Yeah.
Just go on. You know, what's the difference? I mean, indie comics. It's like I'm not the first indie comic that's taken like a year to do a book. You know.
Definitely, yeah. People expect that at this point, like you know.
But
speaking of all that, don't forget to go get yourself a copy of Kill Reaver. It is fixing to go in demand on Indiegogo in 1 hour. Make sure you have to set that up, or you have to push a button to go in demand, or is it automatically?
Yeah, open? I don't even know. I think you just push a button after it ends, right?
Gotcha. I think so.
And also, guys, Berserker Knot is still in demand on Indiegogo, and you still got time to go get some of those.
You know, is there a thing, though, that because for some reason I'm like thinking that it was like, you should have researched that, Randy, because I could have swore like there was something where it was like you had to. Oh, no, wait a minute. I'm thinking when you, you know, extend it, you have to.
You had to do it ahead of time. Yeah, I did. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Never mind. But yeah, anyway, it's been fun. And what the hell? We'll probably just keep on promoting the son, but even in demand. So you guys are never going to get rid of Randy. He's going to be on the show forever. 3 years from now, it'll be at 50,000. Come on.
That's right. And we'll still be waiting on Lil Reva book two.
Well, I just hope that I get the first one done and at least close to what I'm promising, because I got till April, so it's like it's getting close. It's already almost, you know, January. It's like, oh shit, I gotta start getting this thing done. Because Nate asked in the chat, have you finished the book yet? No, no, we're still working on it.
Oh my God, Salazar.
we're hoping, we're shooting for April, so we'll see.
Yeah.
I don't want to be like 2 years late, like some people, you know, or whatever. Like, that's crazy.
Like, Comics Gate.
I don't know how.
Thanks a lot, Comics Gate.
Yeah, April sometime.
No, we're going to throw people under the bus, dude. Like Brutus the Badass.
That's
Those are coming out though.
Yeah, right? They're finally coming out.
Mitch Bradweiser.
Yeah, the Rooster.
Yeah, the Rooster. But those didn't even come out, did they? They still haven't come out. They've only come out in Walmart. If those backers want a book, they got to show up to Walmart and go pick one up like all of us other deplorables.
And also, they were supposed to be bi-monthly at Walmart, and they've only had two issues of their books come out, and it's been like a few months now since. I have a feeling their Walmart deal's going south because like they're probably not selling as well as they anticipated. So we'll see what happens with that. I don't know. Yeah.
There it is.
Better not see Killer in Walmart.
The only way you would see one in Walmart is if I left a copy there.
Yeah. Randy, I'll drive to your Walmart area.
Yeah.
Your copy.
They're all comics in Walmart. They're usually either in the magazine section or they're up front by the cards, like the Pokemon cards.
Usually they have those like bundles of like DC and Marvel comics that you can get or whatever, but
And the Brett Weiser books are up there.
Yeah.
I still have not seen one of those like out in the wild yet. Like they weren't in Boulder Walmart. They're not like up here.
They had like a issue with them getting actually put out in a lot of the stores because Walmart has like they have like a secondary set of merchandisers that they like. They basically the people that put stuff out don't actually work at the store. They work for a separate company that does all the merchandising. So like they've had problems with them not getting put out. So it might be the situation at your Walmart, you know, like.
Yeah.
It could be.
Well, I noticed that they got rid of they had a really cool little cardboard display and then one day I showed up and the cardboard display was gone and the books were all just crammed on a like shelf
next
to some of the books. And I was like, man, I'm going to go out in the back. I bet you that thing's just sitting right next to the
display. Oh yeah.
I didn't get it though, but I should have went back there and got it so I could put my stuff in it and be like, look at this. I put Comics Forge on it and be like, what up, sucker? Comics Forge display over here.
It's probably like the guy who like had to clean the floor all the time was sick of like moving the thing. Just like,
yeah. Oh my god,
good man.
Totally. All right, well thanks everybody for watching. Thanks for coming on, Randy.
Yeah, thanks guys.
Check out Kill Reaver, buy some t-shirts, support Jib and his endeavors.
Right,
t-shirts. The Berserknaut is still in demand. I'm planning on keeping it going for 10 years if I can. I want the record. How long I keep it in demand.
We try to hold that thing in demand until Indiegogo like ends.
Is there a limit? Is there a time limit or no?
I don't think there's a limit. It's like if you don't sell a book in like 6 months or something, they like shut like, it down.
You're out of here.
It seems like before. For the 6 months up, I guess. So
that's funny.
Yeah. And that's it. We'll see you guys next time.
Later.
See ya.
See ya.